When I say viral math problems, I'm not necessarily referring to popular math problems. They are viral in the sense that they have infected the internet, as we do not come to the internet to do maths. You could generally differentiate between two types of math problems, ones where there's a clearly intended solution, and ones that are bullshit. Here's an example of a problem with a solution. Of course, it is not worth the effort of even discussing. This one is more interesting, because it has no solution. This is one of the bullshit problems. Quite a lot of these are bullshit problems, because it is in fact advantageous for these problems to not have solutions. If some poor soul is scrolling, and they encounter this post, and they are too naive to clock the deception that's taking place here, they may well stare at this problem for hours. Which is why the social media believe it has to recommend it to people. Obviously, the most famous of these viral problems is in neither of these two categories I mentioned, as it is not even actually so much a math problem, but a notation problem. This problem has already been discussed too much and does not need a contribution from me. In fact, it is a huge societal problem that so many YouTubers are making content that literally already exists. There is, however, one truly unique-ass math problem that I found that does need me to talk about it. This is remarkably a math problem that is in both of my categories. I believe that it does have an intended solution, but it is also most definitely bullshit. What is so fascinating is that the premise of this whole puzzle is that the victim is supposed to rationalize the incorrect answers that are given. Obviously, 2 plus 5 does not equal 12. Whoever did these sums must have been out of their mind. And it appears that for the final sum, they were so inept that they could not even find the incorrect answer and simply wrote down a question mark. But people are conditioned to not challenge a given premise. This is also how that other bullshit problem works. You are used to math problems having a solution. So that is basically the standard premise that you are working with. People are somehow not quick to assume that they are being deceived. Even though they very well know, not even very deep down, that they are constantly lied to in a variety of ways. So instead of correcting the mistakes in this problem are rationalized. I personally think that this is typical to the human situation. It is the beta submitting to the alpha. It is the lack of autism that we see in the common man. Here it is done playfully as an exercise, but in serious situations too. People rationalize the bullshit that they themselves say or do, or worse, the bullshit of the superiors whose boots they lick. Which inevitably leads to a skewed worldview that creates fresh new bullshit in the spirit of the authority that created the old bullshit. 8 plus 11 equals 19. Don't let idiots or even people with ill intentions rework common sense for you, not even as a mental exercise.